everybody. Welcome to Berean TV. I just recently did a series of short videos before we get into what we call Sunday Seminary, teaching on apologetics and theology and various doctrines, as well as history, because history is important. There were some Israelites that hit me. I had some Israelites asking me a bunch of questions, because they know that I'm down with the Christian church. But at the same time, I understand that there's a movement, and I wanted to explain a little bit of stuff before I got into the actual Sunday Seminary teachings. One brother asked about women with perms in their hair, and he said, well, the white man gave us the perm and this and that. And I stressed that history is important, because in all actuality, the first millionaire in this country, black woman millionaire in this country, is the one that gave us the perm. Her name was Madam C.J. Walker. So historically speaking, when I see brothers out in the street hollering and carrying on and asking questions and thinking the church is damned and the world is damned if a man don't have a beard. So I'm going to explain all of this stuff. Historically speaking, beards were in what we call the Fertile Crescent, what Sheikh Anti Diop spoke of, the two crescent theory on Mesopotamia, and what we call Iran, or what we call the Fertile Crescent, what we call the Euphrates River, as well as the Nile River. Civilizations came up there at the same time, and well-to-do women there, as well as in West Africa and all over the world, they would play with their hair. They would have custom dreads. They would have custom beards. They on braids. They would have custom wigs. They would do all type of stuff, because the women were free. The aristocrat, the men that were aristocrats, the writers, the teachers, they have wives, the queens, they would do all type of fancy stuff with their hair. So that's something that has been around before what they believe is the dominance of European culture upon the entire planet. So a lot of brothers don't understand. We must interpret scripture in light of history. If I'm a student of scripture, or if I'm a teacher of scripture, it's not an easy thing. That's how come I talk about knowing points of biblical interpretation, because we're attempting to interpret a culture that's 3,000, 2,000 and 3,000 years old on a different part of the world. When I read scripture, I'm attempting to interpret that in light of where I'm living now and how I'm living it now, that it could be applied to us. My wife don't have to dress like Sarah, but there are Israelites and there are various Christian groups that think my wife have to dress just like Sarah. Now, somebody asked me even concerning a beard. Yes, Israelite men wore beards. As a matter of fact, all of the three Abrahamic faiths wore beards. The first Christians were Hebrew Israelites. I want to make that real clear. The first Christians were Hebrew Israelites that set up shop, and they were in what we call Antioch, and they were first called Christians there, Acts 11:26-27. So I wanted to explain all of that. They're getting ready to start service up right now, whatever, and they're teaching and stuff. But I wanted to drop this short video. But we have to understand that all of this stuff is what we call the backlash of the European image of Jesus. All of this stuff is the backlash of that, and I'll explain more of that later on. A lot of people left the church because of the white image of Jesus, and that was a major evangelistic tool that was going about with the Nation of Islam. Many people left the church and joined the Nation of Islam in the 60s because of the white image of Jesus, just like brothers are hollering on the corner now with a white image of Jesus, and they're recruiting a lot of people from the church that grew up in church because of that white image of Jesus. So the entire backlash of that we're going to deal with in Sunday Seminary, and how that's how it's affect what's going on right now. There's a move that can't be stopped, and it's the awakening of a people. But I would like it in its proper perspective. There's an awakening of a people, and we're going to deal with history and how a culture has been stolen from another people. And that's a problem. There are people that's pushing that don't want that. And I'm going to teach all of that. A lot of brothers said, oh, we were always all black people that were Hebrews. We're going to explain that. I'm going to explain European Judaism, or what they would call Jewish people, and how they've controlled television, how they were strong in the slave trade. Minister Farrakhan told y'all that 30 years ago, the secret relation between blacks and Jews. So there's a lot I'm going to go through the book, but I'm going through it in light of the Bible. But we must deal with history to culturally interpret it, to let y'all know exactly what's really going on. Sunday Seminary is going to be heavy, and we're going to open it up. We believe in what we call catechism. That's questions and answers. People have always taught that way. Jesus said, "Who do men say that I am?" Socrates, Plato, and Aristotle taught that way. Clarence 13x, the 5% lessons, questions and answers. The floor is going to be open. We're going to try to set up the Google account so we can see live stream, Facebook. I don't know. I'm old, but I'm going to try to get the young folk to help me set that up. But y'all need to register for that Sunday seminary. It's going to be heavy. It's going to be questions and answers. But I want to bring out one last point. Originally, Christians and Hebrew Israelites worked together in the new move of the Messiah. And then we started, the war started with the Romans between 70 and 135. There were three major wars, and a lot in the first century in 70 AD, a lot of believers were ran out, and that caused the ultimate split between the church and those that were known as Christians and Hebrews that went down into different parts. I'm going to explain Europe also, and different in the interior Africa and West Africa, and who got caught up into the slave trade and what later on became British Israelism. And we got to talk about that, because there's people that have stole a culture. I brought that out before. I'm not going to get into the whole depth of it, but it's real heavy. There's a lot of Europeans in the British Isles, and they say they were original Israelites. They were the original chosen people, and they said that for a specific reason. But like the Spirit of God is moving and something is coming up and something is happening, there's a spirit at work. Like what I've always explained in other videos, when an original Louis bag come out, the bootleg bag is right behind it. Ferragamo, whatever comes out, the bootleg is right behind it. It's the same thing with the word of knowledge and the Spirit of the Most High God. The satanic psychics, they're right behind it. So I'm going to explain all of that stuff. There's an original movement that the Most High God is doing and waking the people up. And then there's what we have to explain. I'm going to explain it to you, which is a demonic racist movement that just hate Europeans, and they're on the corners preaching. It's the bootleg movement, and a lot of Christians, a lot of other people see these brothers on the corner hollering, "We're gonna rape your daughters in the New Kingdom," and all of this madness that is not of the Most High God. But at the same time, they're attempting, they don't know that the enemy is using them, and they're attempting to disqualify this movement that the High God is doing. We're gonna explain all of that. I'm going downstairs and see what these people talking about. But if you like what you heard, subscribe. Thank you for watching.